Hey everyone, how was your weekend? Ours was fantastic because, believe it or not, we may finally know how much the PS5 is gonna cost us. And we swear, it's real this time. There's no gold PS5s involved, we promise. So, here's what went down. El Corte Inglés, one of Spain's biggest retailers and the place that every good Spaniard shops at for things like electronics, appliances, clothes, and more. Apparently, they've already added the prices for both versions of the PS5 into their database. The news was leaked via Twitter. Here's the photo, which, just for reference, was taken on Friday, September 12th at 7:58 p.m. We're not gonna lie, the first thing we noticed was how old school El Corte's cataloging system is. We couldn't believe that one of Spain's biggest and most trusted department stores still use software like this. But our colleagues over at Zoomin Games Espanol confirmed that yes, they do indeed, and have been using it for over 2 decades. But despite the system's archaic appearance, if you look closely, you'll see that the catalog merchandise center is a gold mine of information. As you look down the list, you'll see 5 different Switch bundles and their prices. And then that's where things get really good. The last 2 items are labeled as Aria and Enigma, which sound a lot like console names to us. That, along with the fact that the Xbox released their prices, really make us believe that these are the prices for the standard PS5 and digital PS5. Plus, for weeks now, people have been saying that the standard PS5 will likely cost around 499 euros and the digital version around 399 euros. And those are the exact prices next to Aria and Enigma. Coincidence? We don't think so. Also, the price in dollars will be the same as the price in euros. On top of this, the leak seems like it could be real because it's tied to El Corte, one of the biggest department stores in Spain and Europe. It isn't too far-fetched that they would already have the PS5 listed in their system because they have a track record of getting products early and selling them as soon as they're released. If the leak is real, then that would mean that the digital edition of the PS5 is only going to cost 100 euros more than the Xbox Series S. And that there's only 100 euros difference between the digital PS5 and standard PS5, with the latter offering a CD player. At 499, the standard PS5 is the same price as the Xbox Series X. It'll be interesting to see which console sells more, especially since there's no difference in price. A lot of people predicted that Sony would come in $50 cheaper, but sadly, that won't be the case according to this leak. But honestly, it does make sense that they're sticking to $499 and $399, because the PS5 is the most expensive console, hardware-wise, that they've ever created. It includes things like DualSense, which costs around 80 bucks, according to experts. They also say that haptic feedback is one of the main reasons why it's so damn expensive. And speaking of other leaks, analyst Nico Partners and industry expert Daniel Ahmed revealed what you can expect in the PS5 and PS5 Digital Edition boxes. Both versions will include the same items, the only difference being their model numbers, which makes total sense. Each box will supposedly include the PS5 digital or standard console, a DualSense wireless controller, the console base, which is something we always appreciate getting, an 825GB SSD, an HDMI cable, power cable, USB cable, which we assume will be used to charge the controller, an instruction manual, and in this case, a pre-installed version of Astro's Playroom. One thing to note is that these details are based on information gathered from a Hong Kong distributor, which means that items in this box, like the pre-installed game, for example, could change depending on the region. We're pretty surprised though. From that list, the only thing we're not super happy about is the disk space. These days, games are so huge that you'll probably need to invest in a second SSD card. And fun fact, if you get a chance to look at Daniel's post, you'll notice that the last tweet in the thread mentions that he accidentally cut off the prices in the image. But don't worry, Daniel, we've got El Corte for that. Oh, and before we forget, Sony's finally announced a new PS5 event for this Wednesday, September 16th at 1 p.m. Pacific Daylight Time. It'll be around 40 minutes long, and during it, they've said they'll talk about exclusive games and more, which we're desperately hoping includes confirmed prices, when pre-orders will start, and when the PS5 will be released. And don't worry if you don't have time to tune in. We'll have a video all about it on Thursday. The next generation of consoles is really getting everyone excited. We're really curious to see if Microsoft's low-cost console, the Xbox Series S, will pull in more people, or if they'll stick with the digital PS5, since it's only 100 bucks more and has superior features, and potentially way more and way better exclusives. When it comes down to it, we think the console that will come out on top will be the one that has the best gaming library. For example, the fact that people will have to wait for Halo Infinite to come out could have a real impact on the sales of Xboxes. And even though the Xbox Series S sounds good on paper, there's a growing number of developers and experts that say, in the long term, the Xbox Series S may not be able to support next-gen games in the same way that more expensive consoles will. So saving $200 in the beginning may cost you more in the end. But only time will tell how true this statement is. So that about wraps up our video. What do you think about all the news that happened over the weekend? Do you think the leak about how much the PS5 will cost is real? Do you think Sony's doing a good job against Microsoft, and vice versa? Are you happy about the items that might be included in the PS5 box? Let us know in the comments below. And as always, thanks for watching and see you next time.